are splattered all over a wall somewhere, and you've got a job to do. You need to retrieve the package and get it safely to Ronald Lauren and Gurner Shade. Tell him Grady sent you. Get the package, and you'll need the key. I've stashed it inside an old fire hose case in some maintenance closet at Marigold Metro Station. The key will unlock the safe that contains the package. Look for the room marked by a spinning light. You can't miss it. Good luck. And hopefully, they won't find you too. Listening to this tape. My brains are splattered all over a wall somewhere, and you've got a job to do. You need to retrieve the package and get it safely to Ronald Lauren and Gurner Shade. Tell him Grady sent you. To get the package, you'll need the key. I've stashed it inside an old fire hose case in some maintenance closet at Marigold Metro Station. The key will unlock the safe that contains the package. Look for the room marked by a spinning light. You can't miss it. Good luck. And hopefully, they won't find you too. Listening to this tape, then my brains are splattered all over a wall somewhere, and you've got a job to do. You need to retrieve the package and get it safely to Ronald Lauren and Gurner Shade. Tell him Grady sent you. To get the package, you'll need the key. I've stashed it inside an old fire hose case in some maintenance closet at Marigold Metro Station. The key will unlock the safe that contains the package. Look for the room marked by a spinning light. You can't miss it. Good luck. And hopefully, they won't find you too.
Oh! Thank you. I'm only gonna ask you this one time. Give me the naughty nightwear. All right, my mistake. It obviously belongs to you. Now, you just watch it, because I won't be so nice next time. Yeah, just keep on walking.
Thank you. I thank you for your aid. We must press forward. If you are willing to aid us, you are welcome to join us. We were performing a training exercise with one of the initiates when we were cut off by the super mutants. We saw him flee into a building up ahead during the attack, but before we could link up with him, we were pushed back. Now that we've cleared this area, we can press forward and attempt to recover the initiate. I only pray that he is unharmed. Long-range recon. We typically do them in areas that have already been swept and are thought to be clear. Night Church fell in the initial strike. The initiate was cut off and were forced to retreat. He's had enough training that he should know that when facing overwhelming odds, a brother's best recourse is to wait for reinforcements. I suspect that he is making a stand inside of that building, but an initiate won't be able to stand for long against those mutants. Typical. You wasteland dogs have no honor. Very well, I will pay you 100 caps for your aid. Excellent. We will advance forward slowly until we make contact with the mutants and clear the area in front of the building. Once that space is under our control, we will hold position while you enter and recover the initiate. Then, you both should evac to the exterior. You will receive your payment when the initiate is returned to us alive. Let's move out.
Sent you, didn't he? I knew he wouldn't leave me behind. When they attacked, we were cut off so quickly. My gun jammed, and I never even got a shot off. I couldn't do anything but hide. Sure, I guess. Can you fix it? Wow, that's easy. Now at least I can shoot back at those mutant bastards. Are you ready? Right behind you. More careful.
Good. He is safe. The Brotherhood are men of their word, and so here is your payment. Spend it well. Farewell, mercenary. May you find honor in your travels.
Hey there. You've saved my life. I am in your debt.
You have our thanks, stranger. We could not have recovered our ward without your aid.
Good morning, sir. What can I do for you? Certainly, sir. Here you are. 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 I'm sorry, sir. My condensation collectors need time to fully recharge before I can continue to dispense any more beverages. If there's anything you require further, feel free to ask, sir.
Well, how do you feel? Oh, don't think of it. What do you need? good hunting. Unless it's a steaming pile of slag, I'd say yes. Good hunting. Have you heard the so-called android recording? It sounds like an ordinary man. Here's a spare copy of that old holotape. It's a hoax for sure. I guess they sent those tapes to lots of people, especially people like me who are interested in technology. Boy, I wish androids were real, though. Come back soon.
Yeah, what is it? I sure am, Sonny. What have you got for me? Well, all right. Let me count out your caps. Well, back to work.
Well, now, if it isn't the little saint from the vault. We've been looking for you. Someone's put quite a price on your head. What? You think you can walk around the wasteland doing the things that you do, and there isn't going to be someone who takes notice? Such a shame. I hear that you could have been something useful. Ah, well, time to die. Ha! I love it when they go down fighting.
Out!
Just keep on walking.
Well, you startled me. You really mustn't creep up on people like that. Well, I might ask you the same thing. You're trampling about in a delicately balanced and highly sensitive experimental area. My experiments are of a complex nature and would take a scientist to explain. Oh, wait! I'm a scientist! How marvelous! My foray into reducing the girth of these insectoid creatures is of utmost importance. I intend to generationally reduce their immense stature by way of a pre-birth-induced mutagen. Isn't that clever? Let me see. Well, you start with a generation of very large ants. You simply inject the current brood's eggs with an engineered mutagen. Then the next generation should be smaller. Do it enough times, and you may be able to reduce them back to their once original tiny size. Well, this is rather embarrassing, so you'll have to forgive me, but it appears that I've made a slight miscalculation in my mutagen samples. Instead of lowering the size of the ants, the brood hatched and developed a new biomechanism. I call their genetic aberration pyrosis, the ability to emit flame from their bodies. I may be able to correct this error, but I can't get near my equipment. I'm afraid it's not that simple. The mutagen has already been injected into the ant queen. She has enough in her body to last for years. My problem right now is I can't reach my terminal to make the proper adjustments and repair the damage I've caused. My portable terminal is set up in the hatchery chamber near the ant queen. If I can reach it, I can continue to work on improving the mutagen. If she were harmed in any way, months of data would be lost. Your objective would be to eliminate what I call her quintet of nest guardians. Filthy little abominations. I've rigged the equipment in my portable terminal to emit what I call an inhibitor pulse. Once I send this pulse, all of the remaining ants will lose their empathic link with the queen and frenzy, destroying each other in the process. So, that's all there is to it. What do you say? I suppose you're right. Science must learn to acquiesce to your standards in order to advance itself. I was merely going to offer up one of my mutagenic bioenhancers, but I suppose I could up the ante. I will also award you with my old lab coat. It served me well over the years, and you may find it useful for your own experiments. To isolate some of the fire ant genes and distill them into human-safe genetic enhancers. I can inject you with one of these formulas and you'll find yourself with either enhanced strength or enhanced perception. Not only that, but you'll be somewhat more resistant to fire. How marvelous! You will? How marvelous! Be careful, my friend. The Nest Guardians can be quite tenacious. Far too curious. His incessant questioning would often come when I was the most absorbed with my calculations. He had no regard for the importance of my work. All scientists take responsibility for their failures because it comes with the territory. I will take this experimentation to completion without roosting on the moral high ground. If I allow emotions to enter the mix, all this time and energy spent will have been for nothing. I can't risk leaving this place. I have to continue monitoring the hatchery for any further mutations in the next brood. I have no time for children and their petty games. What do they know about the importance of my work? You have your ideals and I have mine. I'm down here to complete my experiments at any cost. If that means the loss of a few lives to save generations of lives in the future, it's a small price to pay.
Yes?
Be ever vigilant. Those from the genus Solenopsis are not to be trifled with. I suppose I could answer a few more queries. I trust your task is progressing. Please don't insult my intelligence. You didn't even enter the hatchery. Now, I believe you have a job to do.
Out!
I've detected some changes within the Queen's hatchery with my equipment. What's transpired? Oh, how marvelous! Please, tell me what happened. Come now, the faster you tell me, the faster I can provide promised payment for your services. Then I will proceed to my portable terminal at once and make the necessary changes to the formula. Thanks very much for everything. You've been quite a useful lab assistant. How marvelous! Here is the promised lab coat. I'm certain you'll find it quite useful. Which injection did you want? Will it be the ant sight or ant mite? How marvelous! Ant mite it is. Hold still, please. Yes, what did you need? You should take him away from this place. Find him a home. It would be difficult to accomplish my experiments with him scampering about and asking an interminable amount of questions.
Yes?
Well, I will continue my research. There has to be a way to reduce these creatures to their former size. Until then, I will be staying in my shack next to the Wilkes' home should you ever wish to visit me. Be ever vigilant, though...
Yeah, just keep on walking.
was so weird. All of a sudden, the ants went nuts and started fighting each other. It was like they were totally crazy. It was really scary, but kind of cool at the same time. You know what I mean? I wish I had something to give you for all the work you did, but I never really had much to start with. I guess now you'll be on your way, and I'll have to try living here by myself. I hope you'll come back and visit someday. Really? You mean it? Oh boy, thank you so much. I'll wait in my old house for you to come back. I need to bury my papa anyway. Just don't forget about me. Well, Papa always told me about my cousin Vera. She lives in some big, giant ship somewhere or something. Papa called the place Rivet City, but I don't know where it is. I wish you could stay here with me in Grey Ditch.
Thanks, stranger. We could not have recovered our ward without your aid. Thank you.
Huh!